Hello, good morning everyone. Today we are going to review a setup to trade pivots breakouts. And by pivots I refer to these bars when we are making a lower low or a higher high. And we have several ways to detect those pivots. One of the most used is the swing indicator. With the swing indicator, we only have one parameter, the strength of the pivot. And we can see we get the signals. And the problem of this indicator is, let's say that we want a strength of 15. 15 means that we have 15 bars to this side and 15 bars to the other side, where all the highs are below this bar. The problem of this is that, of course, we need at least 15 bars to know that this is real a pivot. So even if the pivot is shown, it is only, it paints to the past. Let's see an example. If we move this to the left and we refresh, and now we move bar by bar, this is the pivot, but it is not painted until we keep moving. We still don't have an indication of that this is a pivot. And now all these dots are painted together because this indicator paints in the past. This is a repaint indicator. So we only know that this was a pivot here. For some setups, this must be useful. Maybe you don't have a problem, but to detect a pivot breakout, maybe this is too late. So there are other ways to detect a pivot, and my preferred is the Donchian channel. This was a swing of 15 bars. And let's see a Donchian channel of 32 bars. The Donchian channel shows, let's say, at this moment, we know that this on the last 32 bars, the high was this one. And on the last 32 bars, the low was this one. And we know that on real time. Even if we are here, it is painted and updated bar by bar. So now let's say that we want to detect when a pivot is broken. Like for example, here. Here we have this pivot. And then this pivot, and now we are looking at this pivot breakout. On the following bar, we have a low below that pivot. So this is a pivot breakout. Same here. Here we have a new pivot, and if we look bar by bar on this moment, we have a low making a new low below that pivot, so we have another signal. But Here we have another example, because when we say pivot breakout, we must take into account what part of the bar, what is a pivot breakout, because for example, here this level is from this pivot. And on this bar, we touch and also go beyond that level, but the bar closes below. So for the pivot breakout, I look at the close, and the close is still below. When that happens, it is still possible to get a bounce, because a pivot is a level of support and resistance, so we can get a bounce or a breakout. If we don't break that level, then we get this, a bounce. So we must look at any bar closing on the other side. This bar has a close here, but makes a new high. So now the level to detect is this. This bar has a close below. This bar has a close below the level and makes a new high. This bar doesn't touch the level. And finally, we have a bar that breaks that level, and this is the bar with the signal. And something interesting is I am using a Donchian but with a displacement, and this is because if we use the default settings on the Donchian, we never get a breakout, because the maximum made on the last bars includes my current bar. So each new bar will include its A1 high. So if we move all this to the right at least one bar, so we displace everything to the right, then this line will touch this bar, and now we have a break here. So this is the best way to detect, and we can trade different setups with this. We can trade bounces or breakouts, but let's focus on the breakout. If we have marker tools, we could paint a signal when that happens, and for that we need the high and the low of the Donchian channel. So we use the copy, I will use the name high, and on the input series I place the Donchian channel with a period of 32, and the line is the upper, and we use another copy. Now the name is low, and on input series we place the Donchian channel, period 32, and the plot line to copy is the lower. I get the both copied lines at the bottom. We can overlap to check if everything is correct, and we notice a difference, and this is because the Donchian I am using has a displacement. So on the copy, This displacement on the indicator must be taken into account on the copy. There is a parameter on the copy where we specify how many bytes into the past we want to copy. So we set the one, another one, and now we are on the same page. We could also try to check if there is no difference between what we get on historical and on real time. So let's make a market replay. And both lines are equal, the Dungeon and the copied version. So now we need to detect the crossover. For that we need the close of the line. For the close we need we use again the copy, and let's use the variable close one, because I want not the current close. The current close is the real time price. I want the close of the last finished bar. So we set calculate on bar close to true. And just to understand the difference, let's see the result on with dots over the same panel. These dots are showing the close of each bar. When the bar is green, the close is the upside. When it is red, the close is on the downside. And on real time, we can see that there is no close here, and unless the bar has closed. While the bar is painting, we don't have copied line. Only when the bar closes. Because I don't want the real-time price, I want the last closed bar close. And then check if there is a crossover between one close and the other close. And here we have a crossover with this line. So now that we have the price, we can use the crossover indicator. With the crossover, we detect the close one against the high. The result name for this, that is the distance between the close and the high. I will use close one minus high. And I want to paint crossovers to the upside. Not to the downside. This is a crossover to the downside. And I have no... This is not useful for me. Or for this setup. So only crossover to the upside. This is off. And let's use a color of blue. With an arrow up for the longs. Let's see how it looks. And here we have a crossover. Same here and same here. Of course, the first signal is the best. And now we need to do the same with the shorts. On this case, the only crossover is here. So we add another crossover. Between close one and low, the result is close one minus low. This is just a name for the variable. This is the histogram has a name and I can place anything here. This is not a formula. And now I want to detect crossovers to the downside, not to the upside. So, crossover to the upside, no. And this, yes. And the color, I want red arrow down. Let's see how it looks. And we have this signal because the crossover, another signal because we have another crossover here. Now, if we want to test this setup, this histogram, by the way, is not used here, but shows on this case the distance between the close and the upper line. So this is negative until here, where we have a crossover to the upside. This histogram instead is the distance between the close and the lower line. This is positive because the close is above the upper line, unless we have a crossover to the downside. But on this case, we don't need it. On other setups, we can use this as a filter, so we can maximize the price panel. And now, let's say that we want to test this signal. We add chart trader. And let's go to 5:12 p.m. And we add markers, marker plus, and specify the signals to enter long. An arrow up in color blue to enter long, an arrow down in color red to enter short, and the orders must be executed on the replay account. The entry mode is market. We can use another another type of order, like, for example, the low of the bar. We can use limit and stop orders, but on this case, let's use something simple like a market order. And now we specify an ATM, for example, this one. Click on the markers button, and then we are ready to enable the following long. I will set the manual or semi-automatic mode, so we only take one signal. Yeah, we are approaching to the line.
Order filled.
And we can see that we get a fill at the close of the bar. The signal is detected and we get a fill at the close of the bar. So this is very simple, and of course we need to adjust the time frame and the size of the Donchian channel. The bigger the bars, the bigger the breakout. A pivot breakout instead of a pivot bounce is works better on volatile instruments. So Dow Jones is not the best example. Crude oil or DAX may be much better. So we can also add a filter to detect the volatility, like for example the ATR. ATR shows the volatility, and only enable trades when the volatility is bigger than a certain number. So we can make this setup more and more complex. Okay, hope this video has been useful for you, and if you have any question, please post below. Thank you. Bye bye.